Hello everyone. Welcome to the Why Should I Care About This seminar for semester two. The purpose of this seminar is to enrich undergraduate mathematics education by presenting applications outside mathematics of some of the key ideas which we learn in first year freshman linear algebra and every 2 weeks, we try to bring in an outstanding speaker, some kind of outstanding scientist from another school in NSU or from the industry, to tell us why they care about one of the key concepts which we study in first year as freshmen. This week, this time, we've really struck gold. We've got not only a famous professor, but one of the leading inventors, one of the leading innovators of our time, Dr. Konevsky from IBM. Dmitry Konevsky was educated in mathematics and applied that mathematical education to make inventions, to do great things, which have really changed the world we live in particular in speech recognition. I should move to this one, so, yeah. Today, Dr. Konevsky has, I think, 168 patents to his name, and the White House has awarded Dr. Konevsky Champion of Change for 2012. This is a person who really personifies the type of change which Barack Obama wants to bring. A real scientific leader of our world. Today, Professor Konevsky will tell us why he cares about Hessian free optimization, and this should help us look at the Newton-Raphson method of first-year calculus in a whole new light. Please join me in welcoming this wonderful speaker, Dr. Konevsky.
Thank you for that introduction, and thank you for coming to my talk. As you see, this talk is transcribed. It is transcribed by someone who sits in America. This is not speech recognition. If you have questions, you can raise your hand. Maybe you can go down and speak into the iPad in order I could answer your question. I speak today about Hessian free optimization. The reason why we are interested in this approach, it allows to optimize function of very large number of parameters. We have such functions with a very large number of parameters. When we train this recognition system, we get data, speech data, from hundreds of people for many hours. It's a huge system. And to train that system, we have 100 computers that work in parallel, sometimes for months, to develop system that can understand what other people speak. For such complicated function with large number of parameters, Italian, there's always bank optimization. We have the current year of more than 40 years ago. And as we described, it is the miracle today. But I want to mention one thing. Recently, there was something about different professions. And they were categorized. Each profession is the best. And can you believe the best profession was chosen by the magician who calculated if large data and optimized function with large number of parameters? The profession even was considered better than medical doctor and the lawyer. Therefore, I hope that today I'll teach you a few tricks. That if you continue to develop them further, you will get the best profession in the world. Okay. So, we want to maximize function, let me ask you. So we have an expression that says we want to maximize this function. Let the simplicity consider the case of function of one parameter. Let me draw this function in some way. This is function. F of first thing we do when we want to optimize some function, we check if you can find derivative of this function that equals zero. This derivative, when it equals zero, it's like tangent to this point that is parallel to this axis. So you have several such tangents. Each of these tangents is a solution of this equation. So we can check all these points. Some of them give minimum, some of them give maximum, look at maximum. So we can find the largest maximum. In practice, really can solve this equation easily. If we can solve this equation, we can first try gradient ascent method. Basically, we can start from some random point x0. We can take tangent line to this point. We can take some step along this line and give a new point here. To give that new point, x of 1. That function has had the value
at this point that it had shear. Then we can continue this process. We can take new tangent effects. One. And start again some step size and new point. If we continue this precaution, we eventually will approach local maximum. But if we are close to local maximum, and if we take step size too large, we can overshoot maximum. Therefore, we need to gradually decrease step size when we approach local maximum. We can write the algebraic theory, gradual active method as follows. If we wanted to form point X, the new point is gradual acting revolution. Alpha is step size. And this is gradual derivative of this function. If we have function of several parameters, for example, if we have function of two parameters, like this, now we want to find maximum of function of two parameters. Then we can similarly write recursion at four. If we found already this value, that new value can be found like this. Now, wrote recursion for two parameters. And similar expression can be written if we have many parameters. This is gradual action for function of many parameters. And after is step size. But there's one problem. If we have very many parameters, like million parameters in speech recognition, then it's difficult to find efficient test for alpha. If you take alpha too big, you will overshoot maximum. Your function will not be growing. If you take alpha too small, your increment of function will be too small, and it will take many, many recursion before you achieve local maximum.
for punishable one parameter, or for punishable small number of parameters, the standard way how to find check time efficiently. I will show this concept illustratively. It is come from Newton method. Let us start again from some random point. Let us approximate it by some quadratic function. We can find maximum on this quadratic function. Then this gives you a new point. You find this point on the theorem, and then you find another quadratic function that approximates it, and so on. If you have quadratic function, its maximum can be found very easily. For example, consider F is equal. That it is a quadratic function, and its maximum easy to optimize quadratic function. This provides for functional one parameter. It's easy to do quadratic function to optimize them. In general, you can approximate function using Taylor theory. This is Taylor series up to two terms that approximate this function at this point. And finding the maximum of quadratic function is easy. This is Newton method. Similarly, this method can be applied to a function of two parameters. If you have function of two parameters, then in order to approximate this function, this quadratic function in two parameters, we need to use Hessian matrix. Hessian matrix of this function can be described as full. Yes, I love that. I wrote Hessian for function of two parameters. As you see, it contains four
terms. It has two clear terms. And in general, it should have functional and parameters. In Hessian, we can take n square elements. If n equals 1 million, complete Hessian, and 1 million parameters, complete Hessian, requires computation of million square terms in Hessian. It is very expensive, even for modern computers. Because you put in Hessian for many revolutions, you need to compute Hessian for every data point in speech data. And you have millions and millions of data points is future data. Therefore, the method is not applicable for function with large number of parameters. So we can use different idea how to optimize function with large number of parameters. But as you illustrate this, for function with one parameter, let me first write it illustrating. Now, for any random point at 0, we can extract the following. This function touches each of these points. And this function like the law of the whole function. And this will be not quadratic function. So I'll show how to construct such function. It is different from quadratic function, because when we approximate function with quadratic function, it is not necessarily like the law of the whole curve. It could go over that. But what I construct would be strictly like the law of this curve. And then, when we can construct such curve, we can continue. We can take maximum of this curve. We can again construct this good function, find new maximum, and so on. In order to construct such good function, I will use local. Let me just remind some properties of logarithm and give some new properties. First, logarithm of production is a sample settlement locally is monotonously growing function. It's monotonous to grow the function. It can be drawn as shear. First property that will be needed is that if you connect the point of this curve, that this line runs strictly below of this curve. That property is called concavity. Logarithmic function is concave. It basically allows us to construct the following inequality. Basically, I wrote inequality. The logarithm of weighted sum is larger than the weighted sum of logarithm. This followed from this picture. These are from the show. And to get to the fact that weights are positive, and their sum equals 1. I'm sure in all detail how can optimize their special type of function using logarithm. This function, a polynomial of probability, for example, in case of function of one parameter, this is example of function of probability. We are using probability because this is what we have in speech recognition. We essentially in speech recognition optimize all the function of probability. So we can consider any general polynomial with positive coefficient of probability. But type of simplicity, we can see that only this example. So now we want to maximize the maximum of this function. How can we do this? First, because logarithm is monotonous growing function, we will be maximizing in part this function. If we find maximum of this function, it means to give as maximum of original function of Вы опростимели здесь фарши, здесь type of expression. В этих там. Батыкой. Это должно сказать. А чего здесь фарши, как здесь пикче. Это экспрессия. Я пишу ранку по текст зеро. У них там страх вещи тапов логарифм. У них там страх. У них там страх вещи тапов логарифм. Сядь. That it touches the story at this point, at zero. And it lies below of the whole curve. It can be written as this in a whole picture. Вот он вообще репрезент this picture. Because this is metric type of logarithm. It touches at this point. It lies here in the quality. Okay, this is the quality. And because this term lies below of that term, we have this in the quality. Now, all that we need to do is to find some of this problem. If we find that one that maximizes this function, then it will give us value for f that will be larger than this. It can be seen immediately, also algebraically. So assume that x1 maximizes this function. Then we can write it. Look, the value of this function x1 is larger than or equal. Now, we need this inequality. So we know about this. And because x1 is maximum of this function, it will be bigger. It will be bigger than the value of this function is bigger than the value of this function. Because this is maximum. And we want to know that this function equals this function. So we write. Now we see, because this function equals this function, and this is bigger than this, this is bigger than this. And because this is bigger than this, we found a recursion that increases value of this function. So now, what we need to do two things. We need to show how to find A and B for this polynomial, and how to find maximum of this function, how to find maximum of negative sum. It is easy. Let me write. I got the problem that we're going to find. Mass of length time of logarithm function can be defined as follows. This is maximum of this function. Assuming this property, we only assume here that A and y more than 0 and x is not negative and not bigger than 1. If we have that fact, its maximum can equal this. This you can find immediately by taking the derivative of this function and take it makes it equal to 0. It's simple calculation to the orbit is. So this answers question, how you can find maximum of this function. Now I need to explain how you can find A and B for this polynomial such that touches the third at this point. In other words, how to find A and B that will have equality. And this inequality. This is what I'm showing now. I should start to simplify this as follows. I have and wrote this simple equality. We multiply and divide both expressions because as the same, we did not change this. Next, what we do is the following. We again multiply and divide with the following expression. Let me write that if that we discuss this. What I just here, let me explain. I took some of this and divided and multiplied this expression by some of these. But you see, we did not change this because this denominator equals this, and this denominator equals this. Therefore, we did not change this function. It's the same. Now, we can denote this as M. This expression we denote as M. This expression we denote as M. That we have. Logarithm of this product equals sum of this logarithm. And we can ignore this constant. If that would depend on x, therefore we can focus attention on this. But now, let's denote this as alpha, and this as, let's denote this as alpha, this is as beta. So, now what we have, this as this sum of alpha plus beta equals 1. Alpha plus beta equals 1. Alpha, beta are non-negative. Therefore, because logarithmic function is continuous, we have inequality. Logarithm of M larger than alpha logarithm d. But this expression m is larger than this matrix sum. Again, using multiplicativity property of logarithm, we can write this like free alpha, we can look free outside of logarithm. We can look two outside of logarithm. And you can move this and this outside of logarithm as constant, as another constant. Now I'm sure that we can structure this type of logarithm for our original function. And this method is applicable to any polynomial of probability. It's very simple tree. And we do not need to do so many computations. In fact, there's very simple expression. I could find this sum. It is bigger than to find coefficients of A and B for which to sum that has this property we can define A and B using only the first derivative. We must use the second derivative. And this can be shown very easily if you take the general polynomial. If you compute this, you find repeating this construction, it will lead to this expression. And it can be done for many parameters. And because you do not compute second derivative, it is possible. It's a remarkable property. It optimizes much faster than gradient ascent method. And computationally, the algorithm just proportional to number of parameters. The algorithm was invented about 40 years ago. When he invented this, he gave time to speech recognition. But the first time it was possible to develop speech recognition even 40 years ago. And what interesting, Baum himself went to Phoenix and became very rich, but he always applied this method. And as a connector, I need to study discontinuous now. Our best mathematician who finished top university in America, the gold film, Mr. Brooks. I mean, it will be absurd because I think the top mathematician is the world, not the market. This is a lot. So, what I finish it? I just wanted to be higher than self on this example. And this is extended using this method to more complicated functions other than polynomials. And it's now basic method how speech recognition optimizes functions. So if you have any questions, you can go down in the past. Very good question. What we extended this method to rational function. So we're not using only polynomials. Polynomials are used for maximum likelihood criteria. But we have now more sophisticated criteria. Well, rational function. Also, we are using densities, like Gaussian density. And this method was extended to Gaussian density for arbitrary function, using some kind of approximation from this method. And it's called now extended Baum-Wirth method. I had the opportunity to invent this method 20 years ago. It allowed to extend Baum-Wirth to all kinds of functions. And now, there are new challenges. Cognitive computing. Cognitive computing. And the third kind of brain work. Then we have billion parameters. We have a lot of measurements. We transform speech data using this measurement. And for this kind of function, extended from that method that was a vocal dialect. And you can get now new generation of gesture-free methods. And I thought maybe to get talk about some other time about cognitive computing. And what optimization method we are using here? Did I answer your question? Yeah, good question. In fact, in speech recognition, you don't want to find global maximum. If you find global maximum, you get a called overtraining. If you have overtraining, actions are going down. Therefore, we are usually top to train system after small number of recursions. Not really going to even to local master rather than going. And after we perform one recursion, we are changing object function again. After we are learning new object function from information that we got from one recursion. So, answering your question, speech recognition is very different from simple optimization. It's more like machine learning. Where you learn objective function and adapt it in the process of its optimization. This was one of the reasons why optimization experts, it was difficult to develop optimization methods for speech. Because optimization method that optimization effort developed have fixed object function. So when I spoke to optimization expert 5 years ago, I had the process to contact optimization expert and assure that this method is said, but this is not optimization. We are changing objective function each time. This is why it's difficult for optimization perfect to contribute to this. This is why BAM method, extended BAM method, remains one of the main methods of speech people still are using. Main method.
Please remember to like our Facebook page, and also this seminar is not really supposed to be, you know, faculty telling students what we think you need. It has to come from you, so you have to tell us what you want. We'd like feedback, and this will help us make the seminar better. Please do go to our Facebook page. Please do give us feedback, and thank you very much for coming, and thank you very much for what wonderful.
Thank you. You sent me video. I put some description in the video.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your attention. It was a pleasure to meet you and to speak about such stuff.
Ha, 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 ha.